Hello friends, today I am going to discuss about theories of chromatography. There are two theories proposed for chromatographic technique. First one is plate theory and second one is red theory. Plate theory was given by Martin and Singh, but red theory was explained by using Van Deventer equation. So here first I am going to discuss about plate theory. What is plate theory? According to this theory, our plates, chromatographic plates or chromatographic columns are divided into discrete sections or discrete plates, theoretical plates, and each theoretical plate is responsible for equal distribution of solute between mobile phase and stationary phase. Here I will explain the mechanism of plate theory, and this plate theory was given by Martin and Singh. According to plate theory, HETP is equal to L by N, where HETP is height equivalent to theoretical plate, L is equal to length of the column or plate, and N is equal to number of theoretical plates. So this is the equation for HETP. HETP is equal to height equivalent to theoretical plate, which is L by N. Here L is the length of the column of, or length of the plate. And during chromatographic technique, we cannot increase or decrease the length of the column or length of the plate. It will be constant. Here L will be constant. So what will be the variable? Here number of theoretical plates will be the variable. So if number of theoretical plates is higher, then separation will be better. Means if number of theoretical plates is higher, then value for HETP will be lower down. And in that case, separation will be better for our analyte or for our sample. Now I am going to demonstrate how it will happen or mechanism of this plate theory by some illustration. So here I have taken some diagrammatic representation for plate theory. And here in left side we are taking stationary phase. This is only for illustration or demonstration. And this one, right side part is for mobile phase. M represents to mobile phase, S represents to stationary phase. Actually, this demonstration is only for understanding, but in the reality, there will be no stationary phase in left and no mobile phase will be in the right, because mobile phase will run over the stationary phase. Okay. So here you can see one plate or column is divided into 5 theoretical plates. This is number of theoretical plates. So number is 5. If we are taking 80 mg solute or analyte here in stationary phase, okay, then mobile phase will be continuous running position, and in that condition half of this solute will go to the mobile phase from stationary phase. So 40 mg will be here in stationary phase, and 40 mg will go to the mobile phase. After that, as I have said, mobile phase is continuous running phase. So these 40 mg will go further to the next plate. So it will go to the further next plate, and this solute in the stationary phase will be in stationary phase, and from mobile phase it will go to the next level, means theoretical plate 2. So here this one is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 theoretical plates. Same thing is here also, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In every plate, there are 5 theoretical plates. So, solute from mobile phase is gone to the second plate, second theoretical plate. And in each discrete plate, there will be equilibrium between the mobile phase and stationary phase in terms of solute or in terms of analyte. So these 40 mg will again divide into 20 mg from stationary phase will go to the mobile phase, and 20 mg from mobile phase will come to the stationary phase for equilibrium. So from here it is coming here, it will be 20 mg 20 mg. This 40 mg is divided into two parts. 20 mg will be in stationary phase and 20 mg will be in mobile phase. And here also 20 mg will be remaining in mobile phase and 20 mg will come again to the stationary phase. Now stationary phase is stagnant, it is static, not moving, and mobile phase is dynamic, it is moving. So this 20 mg will go to the third plate from second plate, and this 20 mg will go to the second plate from first plate. So here in stationary phase it will be 20 20, but here it will go to, this one is going to the third plate, it is 20 mg, and this one is going to the second plate, it is 20 mg. Now in third step what will happen, again equilibrium will be there. So this 20 mg will be divided into 10 mg and 10 mg, and there is already 20 20 mg, so it will be 20 20. And again this 20 mg will be divided into two parts. 10 mg will go to the stationary phase and 10 mg will remain in the mobile phase. Now coming to the next step, so in next step this third plate solute will go to the fourth, second will go to the third, and first will go to the second, and the stationary phase will be remain same, it is 10 20 and 10 10, and here it will be 10 20 and 10. Again in this condition equilibrium between stationary phase and mobile phase will be there. So this 10 will be divided into two parts, it is 5 5, and again this will be 20 plus 10, it is 30 30 upon 2 is equal to 15 15. Again same thing will be there, 10 plus 20 is equal to 30 mg, 30 is divided by 2, then it will be 15 15 mg in stationary phase and mobile phase. And this 10 mg will be divided into 5 5. Then in next step these 5 mg will go to the fifth theoretical plate from fourth, from fourth this 15 mg will, from third this 15 mg will go to the fourth theoretical plate, and from second it will go to the third, and from first it will go to the second. Now it will be in stationary phase, it will be same 5 15 15 5, and here it will be 5 15 15 5. Okay, so this is the illustration of plate theory. And after this, after 5 theoretical plates, our sample will be eluted out, because length of column or plate of column is finished, so there will be no separation, it will be eluted out. So in this condition it will give the peak for the compound, and it will be like this. If we are combining both stationary phase and mobile phase compound, then it will be from here it is 5 and here blank, so it will be 5. Now I am taking horizontal in the place of vertical, then 15 plus 5 it will be 20 mg, then 15 plus 15 it is 30 mg, then 5 plus 15 it is 20 mg, then 5, so it is 5 mg. So here peak will come like this. Here in the middle part it is 30 mg, here it is 30 mg, so highest position will be here, and it will be like this. So this is the peak for this separation. Okay, If number of theoretical plate is less, for example it is 3, then peak will come like this. Peak will be narrower. It will separate within 3 theoretical plates. But if we are increasing number of theoretical plates, then separation will be better. Because if number of theoretical plates is increasing, then this will be divided into different parts and the peaks will be like this. Peaks may be separated like this in two parts or three parts. If this is theoretical plate 0, 5, 10, 15, 20. Okay. So if number of theoretical plates is increasing, then a better separation will occur for our compound because HTTP value will be lower down. But if we are increasing the length of the column at the initial stage, then also number of theoretical plates will be increased, because this length will be increased, so it will be 6 or 7 or 8 like this. Okay, so this is the basic fundamental or mechanism of plate theory. Now I am going to discuss the rate theory in second part of this video. Thank you.